We set out to design a pair of self-lacing shoes from Back to the Future. We've got something to show you, Ben. I think you're gonna like it.
These are just the Vessies.
They're not just Vessies.
What the heck are these?
Put them on.
How do I tie them?
Button on the side, little black button.
Oh my god! They're self-lacing shoes! How did you make these?
So flip it up, take a look at the bottom of the soles. So it's just a standard LiPo battery, a standard DC motor, a couple custom 3D printed parts, an Arduino, and then some help with everyone in the shop, and you have some self-lacing shoes.
That is awesome!
It all starts with this motor. It spins, much in the same way a drill does. My plan is to use multiple laces. Each lace will be fastened at one end to the shoe itself, and on the other end will be attached to this spool that I custom designed and 3D printed. The spool is then mounted to the motor, and the pair of those are mounted somewhere in the shoe. When the motor is activated, it spins the spool, winding up the laces, tightening the shoe.
I'll have a nice template to then run along the edges with my knife, and hopefully, with some mild success, cut out the pockets for the shoe.
I've marked on the laces where I want them to meet the spool so there's proper tension on top. Then I'm going to cut them to length, burn the edges, and sew through.
All right, I'm all done. It's time to give it to Ben.
Time for some glue.
Time to join the pieces. Hopefully they fit. So, the shoe is done. Everything's mounted. I think it's gonna work.
You know, it's true. When something exceeds your ability to understand how it works, it becomes almost magical. And that's exactly what we've done here.
Hacksmith Industries is proud to present the self-lacing shoe. Gone are the days of bunny ears, around the tree, and through the loop. Advanced programming, printed circuit boards, and a built-in motor easily replaces all that nonsense. Simply push a button, and you'll be on your way.